At a new spot today. I've been hunting for a while, haven't really found much, and I didn't know if I'd get a video, so I didn't shoot the introduction, but I just found my first thing that I may keep. Do you know what it is? Want to guess? I said may, so you know it's not a cannonball. It's at the end of my pick, so you know it's iron. Let's look at it. It is an axe. Another axe head. Isn't that amazing how many axes I find in the river? It's a pretty nice one. Looks old. I will definitely set it aside and pick it up on the way back through. So I have to go up the creek here a ways and then turn around and come back. That's my plan anyway. I want to hunt up kind of this side, this half of the creek, and then hunt the other half on the way back down. Wish me luck. I just found this little cog or gear. You can tell it's definitely a gear, and it's got a string attached to it, so it tells me that somebody was using that for fishing. Whoops. I'll carry that one out of here. This is kind of cool. Yeah. I don't think it'll ever make it in my collection, but I'll definitely carry this one out. So far, I have an axe, a cog gear, and a couple modern bullets. Not a great start to the day. We're about a third of the way up this creek that I wanted to go, and then we'll turn around and come back down. But you never know. The day has just begun. It's iron here, at least. Well, this might be my first home-style or homemade fishing sinker of the year. Hopefully one of many more. I will look around this area. It's hard to believe there's even fish worth keeping in here. It's so shallow. But we'll go ahead and look around in here a little bit. Maybe we can find a mini ball sinker. That's definitely not a mini ball, but there could be some in here. We'll look. Still working my way up through here. And I got a nice big iron signal right here. And I haven't actually looked at it yet, but it has a nice sound. I'm very hopeful it's a cannonball or an artillery shell of some kind. Now, it could be a plow point. That's possible, I guess. The anticipation is killing me. I like waiting just a little bit, you know, just to, you know, let it sink in that there could be something really neat. It's probably long enough. Unfortunately, the water is very muddy here because it's still, and I've been walking up along the bank, and it's just the mud's following me. So we're just gonna have to listen to it, poke it with a stick, and see if it bites back. It's right out here in front of me. Let's take the machine and we'll find the center of it again. There's a little further out, I think. I thought it was closer to me. No, it's over there. You know, it doesn't sound quite as good as I thought it did. I'm about 25% sure that it isn't a shellfish. Well, let's put it this way. I think the chance of it being in an artillery shell complete is 1 in 10. 1 in 10. Let's hope it's the one. Oop, it's too long. What is it? It's a musket! Pipe. It's a pipe. Yeah. Alright, so. That is called a pipe. That's some plumbing out of somebody's house. Which is probably right up there. It was up there, and they just pitched it in the river. Or someone could use it for a trap stick, too. Who knows? But we're not going to keep that one. I am not the river plumber. Took a little hike up off the creek here. Just hard to figure out where I am exactly. And look, there's some bones. I think it's human. You know, you guys laugh about finding bodies and stuff and the fact that I always halfway expect it. Let me tell you something. Within the past two weeks, within a short area where I live, four people have drowned in the river. Three of them are still missing. So they're floating out there waiting for someone to come by and find them. Ain't gonna be me. I'm staying away from those areas until they're found. I've had my share of that. Well, I see the skull. I don't think it's human. Bones are right here. There's a skull. It looks like a deer. Someone probably shot it and it ran off and died. Or could have died of old age, I guess. That is a doe. You can tell it's a doe because there's no antlers and there's no spots here where the antlers would grow. So that's definitely a doe. Will you ever be right where she lay? Now, just to be clear, I mean, if I was in an area and I suspected there might be a dead person, I will always check that, whether it be an abandoned tent or real strong odor on the river, I always check. But I don't go looking for them, you know, if I know they're there. We'll leave that up to the professionals. When I found that pipe back there a few minutes ago, I thought the muddy water was from me, but it's not. There's something going on here making this water muddy. You know what? I know what it is. I saw a deer out in the creek here as I was coming up about 10 minutes ago. So this is probably about the area he was standing. So it's probably just a deer. If I see his tracks going up the bank, I'll show them to you. Let's just hope it's a deer, not a big ball of snakes under the roots right up here by this tree. Well, I found a bullet. It looks old. It's got the kind of that white patina on it, but it is not. It's actually a plug from like a shotgun, and it's a modern one. When I say modern, I mean post-Civil War. So this is probably, I don't want to date it, but I can guarantee this is from like a 20-gauge shotgun. Maybe fired at that deer that we found on the bank. Horses seem to never be able to get away from the tires. Like every river and creek I've ever been in has had a bunch of them. What that is? Part of a car, I guess. It's odd that it's in the middle of the tire. It makes me think that maybe someone's already come up through here metal detecting it. Yeah, that's probably what happened. Probably been dug over the years, I imagine. A lot of places I go have. I'm not the first in many. I got my first bullet of the day, and it is a musket ball. It appears to have been dropped. It's not mushed in any way. Awesome. Well, if I get another decent signal, it sounds like it could be a bullet. I'll turn the camera on. Water's nice and clear today, so we might get some underwater action. Haven't had any that kind of action in a while, I can tell you. Well, we have the same sort of anemic squeaky noise here that I had with that other round ball. So I suspect it's probably another one just like it. Let's go underwater. These pants I have on feel full of air. They're actually kayakers' pants. I love them, but they're a pain because they hold air and water both. All right, hold your breath. Get the pinpointer out on this one. I do not see it. All right, let's go back under. That's not a good sign. It's not exactly where I thought it was. And it might be deep, though. That pinpointer wasn't hearing anything very well. There's a lot of hot rocks in here that are making the pinpointer make a lot of noise. Nah, just deeper than I thought it was. Yeah, it sounds much better now. All right, let's do some more fanning. Let's let that clear a little bit. Hope you don't mind waiting with me. I'll try to keep you entertained. You see anything? No, I don't see any bullets yet. That's hard. That's rock right there, so it can't be very far. Hope it's not a pull tab. All right, let's go back under. More than one down here too. It might be kind of chasing some around. Oh yeah, I see some lead. I see lead. Oh, I thought I saw lead. Yeah, there is underneath the rock. Let's go look. Take a lot of those little clams to make a chowder, wouldn't it? All right, another round ball. This is the second one in this little area, so there could be a bunch more here. So we'll slow down and really look close, and we'll check the same hole because it might have been another one in here because I'm way off from where I first heard that signal, and I don't think I just rolled across when I was fanning. Right in here is where I found that second round ball. I hear two or three more squeaks in this area. There was none in that hole where I found the one. There's no more. Yeah, that's definitely non-ferrous. There's a lot of fence wire in here too. That's non-ferrous too. It might be the only two I heard. I thought there might have been three though. Maybe it was up here further. Nope. Okay. Let's go ahead and dig this one up. If I can find it again. There it is, right there. Right in that little hollow. It's on a nice solid rock too, so it should be pretty easy to find. Let's go under and look. Have to let that silt clear a little bit and see what we can see. See anything yet? I see some lead, I do believe, over here, but it doesn't look like a bullet. Let's go grab it. Yeah, it's definitely lead. That's a bullet, but it's a modern bullet. I do believe, although I'm not positive. That base looks a little different, so we'll save that one for sure and look it up when we get home. It's a little bit bigger than a .22 caliber as well. All right, let's see about this other one over here real quick. We'll go ahead and grab it, and probably the same thing because it's kind of smaller sounding, wouldn't it? I would have already had them in my pocket and kept going if I wasn't trying to film this too. That's a different one, but let's go ahead and grab this one. All right, put this other one in my pocket. Put it in me pocket. Hopefully I do not have a hole in me pocket. I can't remember where it was, but this is pretty much bedrock, so it won't take long to bring her to life. I guess a ball could be a guy. I don't see anything. There it is right there. Now that could be a buckshot or a piece of bucking ball that would have gone with these round balls. Yeah, I think that's probably a bucking ball. That big, those two big round balls I had are 69 caliber, and a lot of the cartridges would have one of those and three of these. So there could be a lot more of these little ones that I'm hearing. That's probably those other little squeaks I'm hearing too. We'll look around some more. I'm going to turn the camera off though. Sorry about that. Dug another one of those fired bullets that could be post-war over there. So I'm going to move out of that area because this is kind of just a scouting mission of a day. And we're going to look for the mother load. That's a pretty good sized target right there. I suspect it's probably a bullet. All puffed up. All puffed up like a poison pig. All right, ready? Hold your breath. That's gonna take a little longer to clear, I think. It's not, I just saw it, I think. I think I just saw a piece of lead. That could be a clamshell. Right there, is that lead? Nope, that's not lead. All right, pinpointer. Wasn't lead, but I can see it. It's actually a modern rifle cartridge. Looks like maybe a 30-30. Yeah, let's go in there and look at it. Yeah, that's a 30-30. I mean, that could be, I don't know, 100 years old, I guess. All right, this looks like a really good area up through here, though. I'm very hopeful. We'll definitely find more of these modern cartridges. We can't help that, but hopefully we'll find some good Civil War stuff. Stove. I think we will. I have faith. All right. Well, I suppose this is a broken axe. Looks like the bit part of it is broken off. You know, the blade, the sharp edge. It still has wood in the handle. It's a neat little guy. I like it. But I'm not going to keep this one today. We're going to hide it up here against that tree probably right there. Maybe up beneath that root. And I might grab it next time I come through because I'm definitely coming back here. But I don't want to carry this thing the rest of the day. Got a big curved piece of metal here. And I'd say by the looks of it, it could very likely be a big kettle. You know, for preparing food. Something you put over a big campfire maybe. This might be a good little spot. I mean, I got the axe and got this and a couple bullets down below us. It could turn into a wonderful day. We're gonna find out. It's already been a great day. Let's tug this big old piece of iron right there. I thought it was another axe head, so I didn't get the camera out, and it looks almost like it could be part of an artillery shell, like the base. What do you think? go over here and pound it on this rock here and get a better look. I mean, it's just as likely a piece of pipe, but we won't know until we hit it on this thing right here. Yeah, it looks hollow there, doesn't it? Or concave. I think that's a piece of pipe or something. So we can get a good look at the actual surface of the... Yeah, pipe. Surface of the iron is definitely a pipe. That's not any type of artillery shell. Yeah, I should have known. Well, it didn't sound like one. But I should have known that too. We're learning. Just heard this awful scream up river there. I think there's an eagle chasing a great blue heron. They're like flying around. It's probably an eagle nest or something up there. Hopefully they'll come down this way. Since they're chasing each other like that, they won't even look for us, so we'll get a good look at them. Doesn't look like they're going to, though. I'll watch out for them, though, because that might be pretty neat. And this is an encouraging sign. You know what this is? This is a piece of an exploded artillery shell. This is a giant fragment that would have come off of an entire shell. It's not a cannonball. It's like a... might be a Hotchkiss. So there could be some whole ones in here. That's very hopeful. So far we have two bullets, a piece of shell, and a couple axes. We could quit today and be ahead, but we're not quitting yet. Ah, not yet. Not yet. So I took one step and I found a big chunk of an artillery shell. This is actually probably going to be a parrot, although it could be a reed parrot, but it's probably a parrot. So that is a real good sign. That means we're close to that skirmish site that I wanted to get to. So yeah, there could be a whole bunch more of these, or none, or, you know, whole shells, or none, or piles of bullets and gold coins, who knows. Well, I just found another base to a parrot. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. We're going to break this some of this crud off on the rock over here just to make sure. So it was like just a foot from the other one. Yeah, let's try it right here. I'm going to have to switch hands. Have patience, please. Alright, let's break some of this crud off just to make sure that's what it is. Yep, that's definitely a base to a parrot. This is the sidewall right here. And this is the sabot. You can see the sabot right there. It's obviously been fired because it exploded. Nice! Okay, we're in a good spot right here. We'll keep looking around, see what we can come up with. So I've dug four or five pieces of shell fragment in the last 5 minutes or so. And this is the first signal that I have gotten today that really sounds like a shell. It's definitely bigger than one of those fragments that I just dug. And sounds a little better than those axe heads. As I'm looking, I can almost see the outline of it. Maybe. Let's look. I know it's going to be hard to see from up here through the camera lens. A lot of you guys have asked me to get a polarized lens. And the problem with that is they do make them that I can screw on this camera, but they're not waterproof. So the very first time I put the lens underwater, the water gets behind the lens and it fogs up and I have to take the lens off and not use it the rest of the day. Because as soon as I put it back on again, even once I clean it, if there's a tiny bit of moisture, the sun hits it, heats up, instant fog. Alright, that kind of looks like the faint outline of a shell right there. Let's hit it with a magnet and see if it is. I'm gonna let you go underwater first though and wait for me. Right about there, is that it? Oh, that is, that's gotta be a shell. Absolutely gotta be a shell. Tell me the truth. Did you see the outline of it? Come on. I think it is. I'm like 99% sure that's a shell. A whole one. Number six, if it is. Shouldn't count my chickens before they hatch, though, should I? Do you like the anticipation? I do. All right, let's just fan off some stuff and see if that's what it is before we lift it up. Some air on my pants. All right, let's go under again and see if that's what it is.
Well, that's definitely what it is. Do you know what kind? Looks like it has a lead sabot on the back, but I'm not positive. All right, let's pull her up. Looks like a parrot probably, huh? Yes, indeedy, that's a nice one. Unfortunately, the fragments that I found, the iron is really soft on it, which means this is probably a slightly acidic stream. So I'm not gonna knock too much of this stuff off of here on the field. We'll run it through electrolysis first and make sure the iron isn't too soft. That's nice though, it's a shell. I mean, you gotta be happy with a shell, right? Another great signal right here. It sounds a little bit smaller than that shell I just dug. So it means it's either deeper or just a big fragment. That could be a whole one, just deeper. I don't know. I'm gonna go ahead and fan it first with my bare hand, which I don't actually touch the rocks when I do that. Let's just do that and we'll let it clear a little bit. You know what? Oh, I can feel it, it's a round ball. Dude! I'm like 99% sure it's a 6-pound round ball. That's awesome. Like within just, 10 feet of the other one, so. Could be 1,000 of them up here. This whole creek could be peed with cannonballs. I'm never gonna be able to carry all this back though. We'll get the kayak, we'll bring the kayak back next time. I got a little biting fly on my finger. It's not a horse fly, it's probably a deer fly. We'll see if we can kill it, they're not very smart. Neither am I, but he's dead. All right, let's go grab it. Oh yeah, that's what it is. A little 6-pounder. Get it out of the mud. Well, you know what? I'm gonna let this clear and let you see what it looks like underwater. Let me see what it looks like underwater. What do you think? That's always a thrill. Hold your breath. Almost reminds me of a whale egg. Alright. Man, it's stuck in there though. These pants make some weird noises. Chitlins. Alright, we got it. Here we go. Yes, indeed. It's a 6-pounder. It's got a fuse in it, too, right there. That's a fuse hole. Very nice. I hope that iron is okay, though. It just feels kind of soft, like it's going to be pitted. Alright, let's put her on the shore and find some more. Put her on the shore and find some more. Apparently I'm a poet and didn't know it. Thought it might have had a fuse. This was a nice signal, but it's just another 30-30 casing. That's one thing I really haven't found many of recently. That's fuses. I mean, there should be plenty of them out here. Anytime a ball explodes like that, you know, an artillery shell or cannonball, the fuse goes flying. I'm surprised I haven't found any yet, or actually any in quite a while. Well, this could be something interesting in this area right here, too. That's just where I found that weird axle-looking thingy. There's a couple of different signals, but that one could be, that could be a cannonball. It's not reading quite right, but I'm very hopeful since we've already found two. I thought I heard something up here, too. Yeah, it doesn't sound too good, does it? But that does, right there, right there. I think it's a couple different things. Let me go ahead and fan it, and then we'll stick the magnet on it together. There should be enough of the silt off that we can hit it with a magnet. If it's a shell, we should feel it already. Yeah, see, I'm not feeling anything. That probably isn't. All right. Just one more time. I don't know, just... Something about that signal sounds good. It might be a little further up. Ah, there it is right there. It's a big can of some kind. Yeah, it's like a, some type of sheet metal, iron. It's all rotted away. I don't know what it is, but okay. The next one will be a good one. You know what this is? It says ball on it, like cannonball. Except it's really a ball mason jar lid. It's made out of zinc. They sound really good. Almost as good as a belt buckle, but not quite. This is why I'm hearing all this junk up through here and finding all this junk. It looks like a dump. This is the inside of the lid to a mason jar, like that ball lid I just showed you. You can see some writing on it. I'm actually going to save this because people collect these. There's a lot of broken glass, and as you can see, I put my gloves on because I'm not that crazy. It's harder to make a video when I have my gloves on because my gloves have a tendency to get over the speaker and it just sounds like like peanuts, and I have to throw those clips out, so I have to be really careful about that. That's a strange looking doodad right there. I don't think I've ever found one of those. I suspect it's not that old. If anyone knows what it is, let me know. You can see it was bolted to something and it's got a tightener on it, probably like for a piece of pipe, I guess. I don't know. I'm not going to keep that one, but I'll hide it up here, and if it's something good, I'll come back and get it. Or I might just grab it when I have my kayak next time I come. Nah, it's not that old, though. I'm still working this dump area over right here, and I just found this, which is an old plane. Not an aeroplane, but a plane that you would use to flatten or smooth out wood. It's a hand plane. That's kind of neat. It has another name. I can't remember what it is, but I'm pretty sure that's what it is. That's where the blade would have gone across the bottom. No idea on the age of that either. But I'm going to go ahead and put it up there with the other thing. And we'll grab it next time we come out. Want to take a guess at this? Looks like an old crank handle. Maybe off of like a coffee mill or a sausage press or something like that. Some of you may know exactly what it is, but it is some type of crank handle like that. I'm pretty sure anyway, because I've seen those in my hand as I've cranked out sausages before. Yes, I have actually stuffed sausages back when I was a kid. We used to make sausage, you know, when we would butcher the hogs, and it was the most disgusting job ever. Not because of what goes into the sausage, but because of what the sausage meat goes into. It actually have these like big tubs of pig intestines. You'd have to clean out the intestines by hand, you know, squeeze all the gunk out of it, clean them up good. And then you put the intestines, the end of the intestines, over a little hole. And as you crank the sausage press through, like hamburger, it would fill up the intestines with sausage. God, sounds disgusting, but that's the way they made it then. And that's the way they probably make it some places now. It was delicious, don't get me wrong, but it was disgusting to do. The big vats of intestines floating around was repulsive. I'm getting kind of lazy with the camera work. This was a good signal. I went ahead and dug it. Looks like some type of little cranky thing here. It's got gear cog on it. But you know, it feels like lead, which is weird. It's very, very heavy. Don't know what it's for. It's post-Civil War, I'd say for sure. I have no idea about that one. We'll throw that one in the bag. And look it up online, see if we can figure out what it is. If you know what it is, let me know. I'd appreciate it. That's a strange one. Just found this little round ball right here. This actually is not a musket ball. This is a case shot. This would be inside of a cannonball or one of those parrot shells that I just found. And the way I can tell is if you look closely, it's got a lot of little flat spots on it. In case that's pretty indicative of a case shot, because when the ball would explode, the other shot would press against this one, so that it would have a lot of little flat spots instead of like just one big one if it hit a rock. So they're exploding right over our head, no doubt. That little duck right there looks like it's wounded. Look at it, poor thing, flopping around. Oh, what's wrong with it? That's a wood duck, I believe. What it's doing, watch when I walk over toward it. Look, it wants me to think that it's hurt and can't fly because it's protecting its nest, which is right behind me. Now, I'm not gonna go up there, but she flew out off the bank right there. If I went up there, I'm sure there'd be a nest right up in there somewhere, maybe up in the base of that little tree up there. But I'm not gonna mess with it because she's trying to lure us away. She's down there on the bank there on that little bar. See her down there? Wanting us to come down there and eat her. I don't think she'd let us catch her though. Look, there she goes. Now this is one for the books. I think I was rewarded for not going up there and bothering that little duck's nest. This is pretty cool actually. I was walking along the shore here looking for shells. I just happened to glance off to my side. Do you see what I see? That looks like a Civil War belt buckle of some sort. haven't looked at it yet. What do you think? Yeah, that's a cartridge box plate, I believe. See? Yeah, you can see the rust right there? Those, you can see two little like dimples. That's part of the hook. That's a cartridge box plate from the Civil War. That is so awesome. Now, we don't know what kind it is. It could be US, could be CS, could be PNG, could be SNY. Let's look. You ready? It's a US. Nice. Look at that puppy. That's a nice little US plate. It's got a little damage on the end there, which is to be expected after 140 some years or 150 some years. Very, very sweet. This might be a really good spot. Let's put it down and listen to it, the metal detector. I haven't listened to it yet. See what kind of signal it gives us. Usually they're like in the 80s, mid to upper 80s. Let's see. You ready? Well, nice high squeak. Pretty much a solid 80. Wow. Let's make sure we dig these signals. I'm going to wash it off a little bit because it's already been in the river, probably most of its life. We're close by. That's all I'm going to do right there, though. I won't clean it any more than that. Oh, nice. The damage looks like it's fairly recent, too. I absolutely didn't do that, though. All right. Two artillery shells. One plate. Two round balls. Let's see if we can find one more plate. Now, like I said, they usually come in threes. You get the box plate, which is this, which just goes on the cartridge box. They get the belt plate or belt buckle, and then the eagle cross belt plate, which is a little circular one that goes right here. So there could be a whole set here. Could be two more. Let's look. Here's another high pitched little squeak right here. It reads 80, just like that plate. But I dug a can a few minutes ago that read exactly 82, or 80 as well. I don't know, it's buried a little bit, whatever it is. Alright, let's go ahead and fan it a little bit, and then we'll take a look at it together. If you want. If not, just go to the end of the video and you'll see what it is. Maybe. Alright, let's try it with a pin pointer. Looks like we're going to get a thunderstorm here in a little bit. We might have to head back. Alright, let's see if it's still in the hole. Hopefully it is. Plate wouldn't come flying out of there. Can might, though. Nah, I don't hear it unless it's deep. Let's try it one more time with the machine. Yeah, see it's out of the hole? It's probably a can or something light. Well, oh, where it is. That's weird. Yeah. It's gone. It's a ghost. Ah, thunder. Alright. Oh, there it is. See, it's small, whatever it is, I think. Let's go under and look with the pinpointer. Might just be a piece of can or something. I don't see it, do you? You know what Nugget Noggin would call that? It's a stinking Lincoln. You go, Nugget. Well, I have my first horseshoe, and it's a nice one. I'm definitely going to save that. All right, we're going to work our way up to that bend, and then we're going to go back because I can hear thunderstorms coming. It's probably going to get us before we get out of here anyway, but it's getting kind of late in the day anyway. I can only carry so much. In fact, I might have to stash all this and just come back on the kayak. I don't know.
I'll let you know.
I want to see a turtle. Bucky's headed to the cloudy stuff I just made. Oh, he's mad. Look at him. Look how mad he is. It's a cutie. Way you go, buddy.
I'll keep my eye on him so we don't step on him. On a fishing reel, or part thereof, and I looked up, and our goose is cooked. That storm is definitely going to get us. I think we'll be sheltering in place. I think it's supposed to storm for a while, though, so that's the problem. We're going to get wet.
And hopefully not shocked.
Well, the storm's coming. We're just going to hang out here underneath these two logs right here. Because they're naturally not very high, so they're probably not going to get hit by lightning. But we'll stay off the water and stay away from the tall trees, like that one right there. That might make a nice little shelter underneath that. But the reason I like to get these logs when the storm's coming, in case there's a bunch of hail, because a big hail really hurts. So you can kind of shelter underneath these and it helps a little bit. But here are the two shells I found. A parrot and a round ball. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and just field clean them a little bit while they're waiting for the storm with lightning to pass. And I'll show you what they look like. And then we'll get a move on. But I think we'll just wait here a couple minutes first, for sure. Okay, so this is what they look like with a quick field cleaning. I just used this rock here. I just tippy-tapped it to get some of the crust off. That does two things. One, that makes it lighter to carry. And two, the rocks that are stuck to it won't poke in my back in the backpack. That's going to be a nice little Borman shell there. I believe that's a Borman fuse that might be missing. That's going to look real good, though. That's nice and slick. This parrot is going to turn out pretty good, too. Much better than I thought it was going to with those first bases we found, because they look pretty rough. I don't think the storm's going to be quite as bad as I thought it was going to be. But I'm going to call it quits anyway. The river's going to start getting muddy. And get late enough anyway. So, two shells, two round balls, one plate, and a piece of case shot. And a bunch of fragments, like a 5 or 6 fragments. I thought that was Slender Man. Did you see him?
Look right by that tree up there that's bent right underneath it. Slender Man. Let's go.
Enough of that. Let's get out of here. Well, the storm went by, so I figured I'd hunt a little bit more. And I got another cannonball, I believe. I haven't looked at it yet, but it feels like another little 6-pounder.
I'd say you go under and look at it, but it's pretty cloudy, so I'll just grab it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. I was walking downstream, just kind of swinging the machine, not thinking about making it really cloudy, although, like I said, it wouldn't matter a whole lot. It's really cemented in there, though. Jeez, down about 6 inches or so. So I'll get it out of here in a minute. If you want to wait, just hang on just a couple minutes. This is number 3 for the day. I think number 8 for the year. I can't get out of there. It's like cemented into the little rocks and stuff. So I'm going to turn the camera off and go under with both hands and try to pull it up real quick. It's almost clear enough. Want to look at it? Yeah, let's go look at it. I hate to get the pick and pry on it because We don't want to mar it with the hard steel, modern steel. Hitting it with a rock won't hurt it though. Alright, we almost got it now though. I think we're actually underneath it. Still can't pop it loose. Ah, there we go. Are you ready? Oh yeah, buddy. It's another little 6-pounder. That might be a solid shot. I don't see any place for a fuse on it. Nice. I like little 6-pounders.
You don't mind me finding these little guys, do you? I sure don't. Yeah, so it's 3 for the day. Not bad. We're gonna hang out a little bit longer. Sun's out now, so what the heck, why not?
This could be another one here. It's a good size signal. It's a little scratch-elated, but I'm hopeful it could be another 6-pounder. What do you think? I think it's buried too, so let's get the pick out. See if we can feel any attraction at all. Nah, so it's down a little ways. We'll go ahead and fan some rocks out. Try the pick again. Yeah, it's a lot of big rocks in here like that, so it's down underneath them, which is natural because they're much heavier than the rocks, so they would have a tendency to sink down through all the silt and sand and other rocks, especially when it floods. It kind of shakes up the bottom a little bit and things settle down. Let's see if we can feel anything yet. No, not yet. All right, let's test with the machine again. Make sure we're not too far off. Could be down a ways. Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely iron. Got a weird little squeak on it, though, that I don't really like, but you just have to get down deeper, that's all. And we will do that. It won't take us too long, I promise. You guys probably want to go to bed. All right. See if we have any attraction. Oh, there it is. Definitely off to the side. And that could be a ball, I don't know. We'll put the machine behind us. And we'll let this clear out a little bit so you can see. And you'll get to see it at the exact same time I get to see it. How's that sound? All right, fanning stuff away. Gonna get some of the stuff downriver from us. Downstream. It's almost ready. It's almost ready. You know, it's just as black as can be, so probably, well, I don't know. Let's go in there and look at it. It doesn't feel like it's the right shape. We'll go ahead and pry it a little bit since I really don't think it's any type of artillery shell. I'm trying to get underneath it. There we go. It just popped right up. No, it's flat. Ah, yeah, some more of that kettle I was telling you about that we found earlier. I showed you a piece of it. That's definitely what that is. You can see by the seam right here. That's a big cooking kettle. That could be from the Civil War, from the soldiers. Yeah, but it could also be from, earlier than that as well. That's a good sign. I mean, the cannonball was right there, so you just never know. We'll keep looking a little bit longer. I like my hair. It's pretty short, isn't it? Still working my way down the creek, and look what I just found. You know what that is? That's the stock and butt plate to a Civil War musket. Oh man, that is awesome. That looks pretty fresh, this area right here. See this flat spot? So there might be some more of it wedged up underneath this bank. Let's dig around with a pinpointer and see. I suspect the lock plate with the trigger guard and stuff is still in there. Yeah, let's look at it. What do you think? I've turned the camera off for a minute. So this is a little hole right here where I found the butt plate, which is still right there. And we're going to take the pinpointer and see if there's any more metal that we can hear. Yeah, it's buzzing. Oh yeah, buddy. Maybe the whole thing's in here. I mean, it's very possible that the whole musket could still be here up in these roots, so we'll have to dig around a little bit. We have time. We'll make time, won't we? Yes, we will. More. It's in there somewhere.
Yeah, I can definitely feel the trigger guard in there. I don't think this is going to give us much of an opportunity for any underwater shots, though, because it's pretty muddy and the way the current's running here, it's not going to clear up very quickly, I don't think. We might try, though. We'll try to get you a nice little shot of it before we pull it out of the mud. Go ahead and turn the camera off and work on it with both hands, and then we'll see if we can get a quick underwater shot for you. Well, and for me, too. All right, I'm going to show you what we have. This isn't going to be a good photo op because it's really up in there, and every time I touch anything, it gets muddy. But let's go under and look at it. You can see that this is the hammer, musket hammer right there, and that's part of the trigger guard right there. And I think the whole thing is up under the bank. Yeah, it's definitely all there. I'm going to work on trying to get it out of the bank right now. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that instead of waiting until next time, just in case. All right, I'm going to make a command decision here. I'm actually going to leave it in the bank. I'm not going to dig it out yet because I don't have an easy way to get it back to the vehicle. And I'm going to come back with my kayak anyway, probably, you know, next day or two. So we're going to leave it up in there. I can definitely tell it's a whole musket. I can reach up there about a foot or two. I'll show you what it looks like. And we'll just have a little suspense, both you and me. And hopefully one of you guys won't find it before I get back here. If you do, it's mine. That's what it looks like. And see the hammer? And some type of weird gross worm on it. And you can see how the lock plate and stuff is there, and the barrel goes up in the bank. Let's go under and look at it real quick. It's definitely what it is. I want to show you this weird bug too. These things. This one's dead, but apparently they can really bite, and they really hurt when they bite you. Well, I guess you molt it, actually. You can see how the back is all broken out, open like an alien or something. So he's molted, and he's flying around here somewhere. Hopefully not landing on my short hair. Oh, yeah, she's coming here. Look at that now. Yeah, buddy. Look at it. All right, we're going to go ahead and tuck this this butt plate and stock back in there too, and we'll get it all at once. Don't worry, I promise, we'll come back and get it. Just slide it right up in there where that hole I dug, so it doesn't wash away if the river comes up. I think that we're not gonna get any flood, so. Okay, and there she lies. Until next time, I'm so excited. So there's the musket right there, and I took two steps and decided just to try the machine a little bit more just to see if there's anything else in this bank. And look, it's another cannonball. Can you see it? Man, this place is loaded. Another 6-pounder. Look at that, baby. You know what? I'm just going to shove that thing up in there with that musket. Right there, and we'll get that next time too. I already have 3 in my bag. Let's just run the machine over right now, see what we can hear. Now, put the magnet up there. Wait, let's see if there's any more in here. All right, ready? Here's some little squeaks. Small pieces of iron. Oh yeah, there's something there. What's that? There's something right there too. What is that? So is that glass? Yeah, that's an old bottle, huh? It could be silverware. A whiskey bottle or something. Let's just go down through here real quick. Well, I got you. I don't think I can dig anymore though. We'll get my kayak and we'll load my kayak up. How's that sound? Yeah, I don't hear any more here. Huh?
Okay.
And that is it. We're done for the day, I promise. I might carry that cannonball. Yeah, I'll carry that cannonball out, though. And maybe do a quick wrap-up on the end down there. But I'm going to have to leave the musket, of course, because I don't want to break it. Are you ready? Let's go.